हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज भूमिका पाटिल, सीनियर लेक्चरर इन इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी भाईंदर। द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ इमर्जिंग ट्रेंड्स इन कंप्यूटर एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इज बेसिक्स ऑफ डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक। फ्रॉम दिस वी आर गोइंग टू सी पार्ट वन, लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ पार्ट वन इन थर्ड चैप्टर आर डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक्स। इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन, हिस्ट्री, रूल्स, डेफिनेशन एंड गोल्स। सेकेंड आउटकम इज मॉडल्स ऑफ डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक इन्वेस्टिगेशन। द मॉडल्स आर डी एफ आर डब्ल्यू एस, ए डी एफ एम, आई डी आई पी, डबल ई डी आई पी, यू एम डी एफ एम ए, यू एम डी एफ पी एम। एंड थर्ड लर्निंग आउटकम इज इथिकल इश्यूज इन डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक आर इथिकल नॉर्म्स एंड अनइथिकल नॉर्म्स। इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक। फॉरेंसिक साइंस इज अ वेल एस्टेब्लिश साइंस दैट प्लेज वाइटल रोल इन अ क्रिमिनल जस्टिस सिस्टम। इट इज अप्लाइड टू बोथ क्रिमिनल एंड सिविल एक्शंस। डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक, समटाइम्स नोन एज डिजिटल फॉरेंसिक साइंस, इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ फॉरेंसिक साइंस एनकम्फसिंग द रिकवरी एंड इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफ मटेरियल फाउंड इन डिजिटल डिवाइसेस, often in relation to computer crime. Digital forensic includes the identification, recovery, investigation, validation, and presentation of facts regarding digital evidence found on computers or similar digital storage media devices. History of forensic. Field of PC forensic began in 1980s when personal computer became a viable possibilities for the buyer. In 1984, an associate Federal Bureau of Investigation program was created, which was referred to as a Magnet Media program. It is currently referred as Computer Analysis and Response Team. Michael Anderson, the father of computer forensic, came into limelight during this period. International Organization on Computer Evidence was formed in 1995. In 1997, the great countries declared that law enforcement personnel should be trained and equipped to deal with sophisticated crimes. In 1998, Interpol Forensic Science Symposium was apprehended. In 1999, the FBI CART case load goes to beyond 2000 case examining 17 terabytes of information. In 2000, the first FBI Regional Computer Forensic Laboratory was recognized, and in 2003, the FBI CART case load exceeds 6,500 cases, examining 782 terabytes of information. Rules of Digital Forensics. While performing digital forensics investigation, the investigator should follow the given rules. The rules are, first one, an examination should never be performed on the original media. Rule 2, a copy is made onto forensically sterilized media. New media should always be used if available. Rule 3, the copy of evidence must be exact bit by bit copy, sometimes referred to as a bit stream copy. Fourth rule, the computer and the data on it must be protected during the acquisition of the media to ensure that the data is not modified. Rule 5. The examination must be conducted in such a way as to prevent any modification of the evidence. Rule 6. The chain of the custody of all evidence must be clearly maintained to provide an audit log of whom might have accessed the evidence and at what time. Definition of digital forensic. Digital forensic is a series of steps to uncover and analyze electronic data through scientific method. Major goal of the process is to duplicate original data and preserve original evidence, and then performing the series of investigation by collecting, identifying and validating digital information for the purpose of restructuring past events. Digital forensic investigation. Digital forensic investigation, DFI, is a type of investigation where the scientific procedures and techniques used will be allowed to view the result digital evidence to be admissible in a court of law. Here are some goals of digital forensic investigation. The main objective computer forensic investigation is to examine digital evidences and to ensure that they have not been tampered in any manner. To achieve this goal, investigation must be able to handle all below obstacles. Handle and locate certain amount of valid data from large amount of files stored in computer system. It is viable that the information has been deleted. Such situation, searching inside the file is worthless. If the files are secured by some password, investigators must find a way to read the protected data in an unauthorized manner. Data may be stored in damaged devices, but the investigator searches the data in working devices. Major obstacles is that each and every case is different. Identifying the techniques and tools will take long time. The digital data found should be protected from being modified. It is very tedious to prove that data under examination is unaltered. Common procedure for investigation and standard techniques for collecting and preserving digital evidences are desired. Thank you. Here we end with the first part of basics of digital forensics.